Welcome to the class 12 students. This is the part 3 of the chapter Biodiversity. In my previous video, I started with the topic of loss of biodiversity and I have discussed 4 reasons of the loss of biodiversity. The reasons that I have discussed are habitat loss and fragmentation. That means the living place of the animals are being destroyed for human settlement, to make dams, reservoirs, to make mining sites. So all these demands are leading to the loss, are leading to the destruction of habitats of animals or plants. As a result, they are also getting extinct slowly, which is leading to loss of biodiversity. Okay. Next point that we discussed is over-exploitation. Over-exploitation of any plants or animals will obviously lead to loss of biodiversity. Third point is alien species invasion, which means if alien species or any foreign species tries to come and invade a place, that may lead to a competition between the already existing species, and ultimately loss of biodiversity will take place, since competition is a negative type of interaction. Okay. Fourth reason was coextinction. One species which depends on other species, if the other one dies, obviously the one depending on that other species will also die slowly, which will make an instance of coextinction of two or more species. Okay. So we will start with the fifth point today. So we are doing the loss of biodiversity. Fifth point is disturbance. Natural as well as man-made disturbances such as fire, tree fall, defoliation by insects, etc. affect communities adversely. Man-made disturbances and degradations are more severe. They include falling of trees, use of fire for clearing, collection of litter and over-exploitation of other economically important species. So all these kinds of disturbances, either man-made or natural, will disturb the natural lifestyle of the animals or the plants in a forest or in a particular ecosystem. And these disturbances will ultimately cause to loss of biodiversity. Okay. Next is pollution. We all know there are so many types of pollution and how harmful all these types of pollution are. Okay, pollution may reduce and eliminate populations of sensitive species. Sensitive species means those species which cannot tolerate large amounts of pollutants within them, and as a result will die ultimately. So even if they are even if we are not talking about sensitive species, other species also may be affected hugely due to pollution. Okay. Next is intensive agriculture. Intensive agriculture, due to meet the increasing demands of agriculture, of foods, of productivities which are being cultivated in lands. Okay, in farming lands, to meet those increasing demands, agriculture, the rate of agriculture has also increased. And where will that land, extra land, come from? Obviously by deforestation, by cutting trees, by destroying the habitats or the living spaces of animals, and as a result those places can be converted into an agricultural land, where agriculture or cultivation may be done to meet the increasing demands. Okay, but this conversion or destruction of the habitats of different species is ultimately leading to loss of biodiversity. We are again pointing to the first point of loss of biodiversity was habitat loss. So here also habitat loss is taking place due to intensive agriculture. Okay. Next point is forestry. Growing economically important plants for commercial purposes reduces the number of other species in the forest, like sal, teak, shisham. All these trees are economically very, very important, commercially very important. But to grow these things, to grow the economy of our country, these trees are being grown more than the other species. They are given more attention than the other species. As a result of what is happening, that those other types of trees or animals also, which are not that much commercially important, they are not getting their place to live, they are not getting much attention. So as a result, obviously, loss of biodiversity is taking place. Lastly, not the last one, second last one, hunting and poaching. Hunting means, you all know, to kill commercially important animals. Poaching means to take them out of the forest illegally, to sell them outside of the country, which will be sold at extremely high price, and as a result, some people will be commercially or economically helped. But this is illegal. Hunting and poaching both are illegal. Okay. And the last topic is, last reason is deforestation. I hope I don't need to elaborate deforestation, because you all know what is deforestation. It means the cutting of trees, and cutting of trees is ultimately leading to loss of biodiversity, and trees can also be a habitat for different types of animals or birds. And deforestation means cutting of trees can lead to co-extinction, which I have discussed in the previous video. Co-extinction means, since their place, living place, is not there anymore, as a result, those species which depend on these plants are also getting extinct slowly. Okay, so this is all about the reasons of loss of biodiversity. So we have discussed 10 reasons in total. Let me give a small recap of all the reasons, and then we can move on to the next topic. Okay, so the first four reasons that I have discussed in the previous video are habitat loss and fragmentation of habitat, means breaking down into small parts of the habitats, overexploitation of plants and animals, overexploitation of grazing fields, alien species invasion, which leads to competition and thus loss of biodiversity, co-extinction of two species which mutually depend on each other. Then we have started today, disturbance means any kind of natural or man-made disturbance will ultimately lead to the destruction or a disturbance in the lifestyle of the species, plant or animal, and thus they may die slowly. Next is pollution, intensive agriculture. Next, forestry, hunting and poaching, which is very, very illegal and also very, very common in our country. Even if it is extremely illegal, it is very common, because people are there who are doing these things regularly to earn money. And the last one is deforestation. So I hope this topic is clear to you all. In the next video, we will continue with the next topic, which is threats, which is a need for the conservation of biodiversity. Okay, thank you.